We love you, Meghan. Screaming and sobbing fans line the streets of Wellington to greet Prince Harry and his wife as they kick off their New Zealand visit. They're currently embarking on their first overseas visit as a couple, and Prince Harry and Meghan Markle have been given a warm welcome wherever they've gone. And their visit to Pukiu National War Memorial Park in Wellington on Sunday was no exception, as the Duke and Duchess of Sussex were met with enormous crowds waiting to catch a glimpse of them. Some were crying and shouting, while others were holding welcome banners, with one reading "Harry and Markle make a little sparkle." The mother and father-to-be arrived in the country from Sydney today for the final stretch of their marathon 16-day tour, which has also seen them visit Fiji and Tonga. Cameras captured royal fans waiting patiently for their arrival as they visited the park to lay a wreath on the memorial. A group of young women looked excited as the anticipation built up, with one member of the group eventually breaking down into tears. Another group brought along a sign that said, "We heart you, Meghan, Harry's all right too, sick," which one of them excitedly held up for the cameras. One woman attached a sign to the railings that said, "Pregnancy suits you, Duchess," alongside a picture of Meghan, 37, as her suit's character Rachel Zane. One young boy with red hair, wearing a blue bow tie, was seen holding a sign that said, "Hi Harry, I'm Harry." Two 10-year-olds who waited hours for a glimpse of the couple got more than they bargained for when the Duke and Duchess of Sussex agreed to pose for a picture. The couple were given gifts including a buzzy bee, a popular toy from New Zealand, which Harry held in celebration after it was passed down through the rows of crowds. Pictures of Harry's brother, the Duke of Cambridge, playing with the toy during the visit of the Prince of Wales and Diana in 1983 made front pages around the world. Meghan and Harry, 34, looked in high spirits as they received the warm welcome today. Meghan wore a black maternity dress from Asos teamed with a trench coat from New Zealand designer Karen Walker. Both Harry and Meghan laid fern fronds on the tomb of the unknown warrior, then laid a wreath before heading into the building. Meghan spoke with several women, including one who told News Hub she'd flown all the way from California to meet her, and had been able to speak with her about being biracial. The Duchess was gifted flowers, a teddy bear, what appeared to be a bag of lollies, and a red flower which she pinned to her jacket, underneath her Anzac poppy. Harry and Meghan will spend their evening at an official dinner, before kicking off Monday with breakfast at a cafe and then heading to the Awol Tasman National Park.